My dear friend, Dr. Abdul Taha, and my dear friend, Professor Farida Siddiqui, and Honorable Vice Chancellor of this university, and other administrative academic members, for giving me this opportunity today evening, and such a program of your university. And today's as per request, they asked me to talk on strategic planning management in the higher education system in India. So first of all, I will start with the brief conceptual analysis of the strategy, planning and management, and as well as higher education. Then after clarification of the concept, then we will see the higher education situation in India and the particularly university system, and more focused on your own university. And I want to start this lecture with a small case study. I think I request all my friends, colleagues of the faculty of the Manu University, not to expect this lecture as a conventional routine lecture. Topic is somewhat different topic. And that's why I want to go with a different way of interacting with you with a small case study. This case study will highlight the whatever the today concept, today topic is given, like a started planning, management and strategies of higher education. I feel that I may give some inputs which you realize for your institutional growth as well as your professional career. Because as far as my knowledge is concerned, that this program is induction program. So my lecture may help. And sometimes hostile environment of any institution, any organization. So this is the one that means now choosing how best you are. And then there will be this organization means, you know, the organization is a multi task force activities. So it is a sometimes dynamic or sometimes static, stationary, sometimes hostile. So different environments we can see in the organization. In those environments, how can you best? That is the respond to any situations. That is one. That is meant to respond to any situation. You will have the develop. You have to have a strategy to handle the situations. And then another thing is recognizing the choices. That means now any problems come in the organization, you will have the different choices how to handle these issues. And among the choice, if you have the choice, of course, individual organizations have the several multiple choices. Among these choices, you have to select only one choice. Some disturbance. Please, I request all the people to mute your speakers. And selecting the choice and committing for one set of the responses instead of another. Because if you commit for multiple things, then you won't achieve anything. This is the one. So broadly, definition of the strategies or actions or tactics or decision makings or whatever you call this. And if you go to third slide, so first next one, what we see generally the organizations are individuals to formulate the process of formulation of the strategies. So the education, put it as higher education as an organization, as education as an organization. As a part of higher education, we take it as a university. University is an organization, an institution. So in this case, we have to adapt the strategies. While adapting strategies, what we have to do, we have to select the strategies first. So they for to select the strategies, there is a process. We have to follow the process. This process, what is the formulation process, formulating the strategies? First, generally, mission. What is the mission of the organization? So, of course, affordability of education because of the fee structure and quality of education because of the competition and employability of the education. So, these are the issues, main issues, why the education is. Of course, all these things are available in new education policy of 2020. As I think everybody might have seen the right. Now, why we want to go for strategy management for higher education? Because the education, because of the competitive nature, every institution organization is going for creating the brand of image. The institutional image or institutional brand. So creating the brand. For example, we have any top universities you see, they have the brand. For example, Oxford, immediately people will feel that it is a brand. At any university, if we take that JNU, it has brand, right? In University of Hyderabad, we had brand. So it means now strategies need background of the strategy means to create the brand of organization. And why this brand creation? What is the need of the brand? The brand creation of the brand is to face the competitive advantage, to take the competitive advantage. Why this competitive advantage? Because now the education is now just everybody knows that is a commercialization of education because of the private sector is also playing. Now we have to treat this higher education as a corporate activity. When you go for the corporate activity, immediately we have to see the different strategies. Conventional, traditional strategies will not work in the competitive world because of now the globalization of the education. All international, national organizations are competing each other. While competition is increasing, then the institutions will go for different strategies, different planning to create their image, to create their brand of education, to attract more students, to establish themselves, the organization. Right, this is a brief background. So in this process, organizations will go for the formulating the strategies. First, formulating strategy, first step will go for mission, creation of the mission. Each and every organization will have the mission. Mission means now, this, we want to do this, we want to do this, we want to achieve this. It may be long-term. Mission means it is a long-term. Of course, next slides, we'll come to the mission vision of our Manu University. I'll explain all this, we'll see, right? And then after creating the mission means simply what you want to do, what you want to achieve. That make it is very clear, specific, more crystal clear what you are going to do. That is the mission. Then to achieve the mission, people will go for to create the different goals. It is a mission means only one statement or one complex of one statement, clarity. And for example, now that to achieve the missions, organizations will have the goals, develop the goals, different goals. Yes, this is my goal number one. Number goal is that my university must be the state country's number one. For example, research number one, education top, international. For this, what happened nowadays in the competitive world, people are going to create the rankings. We have the different ranks, national ranking, international ranking, global ranking, or another is our own accreditation, NAC. Whenever the NAC comes, everything will be clean and green. Curtain, office, furniture, chairs, cupboards, computers, whatnot, everything will be available. When the NAC is coming. Remaining times, same as it is, as we follow this. So that means now, what I mean is that a goal, each and every institution organization will have the goals, maybe multiple goals, number of goals. Right. After creating the goals, now generally the organizations will analyze the internal environment. Internal environment. Who are the students? Who are the stakeholders? What are their level? What is their background? And faculties. What is strength of faculty? What is the capacity of the faculty? Research, infrastructure, facilities, classrooms, equipments, all administration supporting, all these things we'll analyze internally. The school system, our departmental system, all systems will analyze this. And then we'll analyze the external environment. External environment, of course, political, social, ecological, economical, and cultural. We will see different aspects which are involving or affecting our mission. Right? This we'll analyze. And for this, generally the competitive organization or corporate organization or any organization, any institutions will go for the SWOT analysis. SWOT analysis means the organizations will identify the strengths, the organizations will identify the weaknesses, the organization will identify the opportunities, and organizations identify the threats. So after analyzing all these four concepts, then people will go, the organizations will go for strategy. What type of strategies we require? This is the strategies. That's why the formulation of the strategies. Of course, this formulation of the strategies, anybody can do. It can be done by individuals. It can be done by organizations. It can be done by departments. It can be done by the school. It can be done by the centers. So it is open for all. Anyone can do it. Right? Then we'll go for the strategic planning. Strategic planning. So next slide. The strategic planning, we say that direction of the university, management of directing the university toward the development of it, and developing the decision making, what type of decisions are required. Sometimes organizations, many decisions, the way chancellors are, executive councils are, different apex bodies will take the decisions, decision making. And then allocation of resources, the plan as part of the plan, which department, some departments getting the more funds, some departments getting less funds, there is a conflict of interest. Of course, all this strategic planning and control mechanism and formulation and implementation of the decisions and actions, activities, academic activities, research activities, community activities, any activity, with curricular activities, student activities, any activities. And then strategic planning again is a process of determining the long-term as well as short-term goals of the university or the university or organization, whatever it is. And then identifying the best approach or tactics to achieve the goals is a plan of strategic plannings. And as again, strategic planning is overall the planning of facilitating the good management of the process. And again, it is a framework of big picture of what you are doing, where you are doing, how you are doing, why you are doing. This is a part of the planning. And overall, basically, it gives the clarity of what you actually want to achieve and how to achieve it. And it is this strategic planning will explain each and everything. Clarity of what you actually want to achieve. What you want in organization, in the university. And once you are clear about the what you want, what you achieve, then how to achieve it? How to achieve this? And then this is a then simply we can say that one word, it is a sketched document describing where an university or an individual wants to be in the future. And then broad areas of activity that will undertake to achieve it. So after understanding, I want to give you, after understanding the strategic planning, it is overall transforming the position of university to a more desirable or competitive positions. For example, this year student strength is this much. Next, after next 30 years, 20 years, 40 years, what is this? So this, when the university, your university started 1996 or 1999, exactly. So what was the university? Now what is the university? Now what will be the university in future? What is the strength? What is the capacity? What is your brand? What is your image? National or international? So this, everybody will have this type of strategic planning. So then, next come to the strategic management. So now, of course, now it is a strategy is over. Strategic planning, and next is strategic management. Strategic management defined by the Wright and Pringle and Cole, identifying the vision, mission, objective of organization. Objective of the organization. One is develop the, identifying the vision, identifying the mission and objective of the organizations. So this, it will give the clarity, crystal clear that what you are, what is this, what is the identity, what you are going to do, what you want to achieve in organizations, right? This identifying the vision, mission and objectives, and then developing appropriate strategies for the university. So that means what you're developing the vision and the mission, just sleeping that, then there is no use. So then we have to put effort to achieve the vision and to realize our vision, realize our mission and achieve our objectives. So to achieve our objectives, realize our mission, realize our vision, then we have to develop the appropriate strategies. What are the strategies? So to know these strategies, after knowing this, after this concepts clarity, clear analysis, then I will give one case study. I will give the case study. While explaining the case study, I request all the participants to make the, what are the strategies, what is the mission, what is the vision, what is the objective, what is the goal, everything I think you will realize. Then strategic management, part of strategic management is one more important concept is that implementing the strategies. So implementation is one part, is the major part. Of course, who are the implementers? Who are the executors? The executors are here that, of course, we have the supporting staff. That is the administration, we say the management. And then just after implementation of these strategies, then we see that whether these strategies are success or fail. So we have to see the monitoring the implemented strategies. So one strategy is failed, then in that place, we have to for other strategies, alternative strategies. So then the collective activities, again, activities, and each and every activity must be under the coordinating system. So by incorporating, by looking at all these concepts, strategic management is nothing but the transformation of the university into the new level. That is the university. So new level means what? Student strength will increase, enrollment rate will increase, faculty strength will increase, departments will increase, expansion of the university totally. Just go for new level. It is ranking will increase, and NAC A plus plus, of course, different ranking system it will be. Then after that, I will explain things. And then here there is a strategic management. Generally, organizations or universities again will go for this strategic management cycle. That is the first. We'll go for the SWOT analysis. And after analysis, we appraise the weaknesses, strength, all the opportunities for the university, for the organization, and then formulating the policies and planning, that is the goals, strategies, and then operational part, implementation of this, and monitoring, and after evaluation. This the cycle of the process will go. Each and every organizations will go the process. All right, this is the strategic cycle everybody will see. Then now, as a faculty members, as assistant professors, as a teachers, just you yourself. Next slide, please. Next slide. Self-analysis. Each and every individual in the organization, we have to analyze ourselves. Who are you? Who are you? Everybody will say that, yes. Yeah. Each and every individual human beings have multi-dimensional personality, multi-task person. Right? Multi-task persons. Human beings. Because we are ambitious. We have so many ambitions. Right? In these multi-dimensional personalities, who are you? What is your priority? Right? What you are doing now? What first? Who are you means what? Are you a teacher? Or else? Are you something else? Why this question is here is importance of this question is that sometimes I have seen some teachers generally, they are doing teaching, they are well settled in the, but apart from their profession teaching, they will be looking for some more occupations for earning money. So in this, that means is a multi, what is what you are, that's what, who are you, whether you are really teacher. If you are the really teacher, then you identify your responsibilities and you are identify your commitments. Right? Then after this, once you realize that you are the teacher, you are assistant professor, you are a professor, you are something else, then what is your capacity? How capable are you to do your job? And your capabilities lacking something, and how to equip your capacity? All right, thus you have to analyze yourself. For this, each and every question, if you analyze, then again, I request you, you can go for the strat analysis of each individuals. And then, in this process of this, identifying the process, identifying your capacities, what are the problems you are in the organizations? Each and every individuals will face this. In my case study, I think you will come across all these things. Then, in the competitive world, you are lucky enough that you are working in a central university with the same qualification, people are struggling on the roads and the market for jobs. But we are lucky enough, we are in the good system. In the system, we are working. But that is not sufficient. Something else we have. We need to develop, that is how different you are from others, because this is a competitive world. This is a competitive world. Everything is competitive. Promotion is competitive. Interview post is competitive. Everything is competitive. The world itself is competitive world. Now we have to fight. So in the fighting, you must be different from others, innovative from others. And then, what are the critical issues to you? Then between, so you'll come across so many issues in the organization. Right? In the issues, What is your priority? Critical issues. Which issue you are facing? That is you identify, analyze, and then whatever the resources, whatever the opportunities you have, how do you allocate your resources? Because every individual, every university, the problem is that scarcity of the resources. The scarcity of resources, we have to go for optimal utilization of the resources. When optimal utilization of resources, you have to go for the best use of your resources. That we have to be. And what is your immediate objective? Immediate objective. That means, objective means you will have the different goals. I want to do this. I want to do this. I want to do this. The different goals. These goals, you have to prioritize. Prioritization of the goals. Then, how do you organize yourself to achieve your goals? Right? Whom do you approach? Who will help you? Who will show the ways? Who will support you? Right? And what you require? What is required? When is it required? Your own capacities. Right? When you are all those things, who, what, when? So that means now, in this way, if you organize yourself to achieve your goal. Right? This is the self-analysis. And then, of course, before going to say next slide, now I am to give the one in this a small case study. One of my friend, he had joined a central university as an assistant professor like you, and he was very honest person, very honest, academic honest, and commitment for the organization, and confined to the only his jobs, responsibilities. What are the responsibilities? Teaching and research. Mainly these are the responsibility in the university, any teacher. Teaching and research. So now that guy was doing the teaching as well as research confined to his own responsibilities. Then what happened? One fine day, one the vice chancellor, good vice chancellor, honest vice chancellor came to the university as a vice chancellor, newly appointed. And you want to go for this strategic management and planning all this and to develop the university and to change the landscape of the university. Right? And then he identified the people, resources he identified as a leader, academic leader, his job is to identify the resources. And he selected that person as a assistant professor, as a OSD for the university. Right? So that means the OSD means is the administrative post or supporting administration. So when that lecturer or assistant professor was appointed as a OSD, then the university senior faculty members, totally their attitude, their behavior totally changed. What changed? Non-cooperation started. Why the non-cooperation? Because this type of, generally we are teachers. We are teachers means generally we'll teach, we'll do research. That is our prime responsibilities. But that's what, if you are not analyzing who are you, right, then these type of questions will arise. Then they started non-cooperation in that organization, in the university. Then, of course, some way they try to destabilize the administration, university administration. And that person started working in the university as OSD for 3 months. And is by looking at his strategies, actions, and activities, and streamlining the system, the people, the old system, right? Traditional system, people are not able to digest. As a result, they started the revolt. The revolt arose in the way of they could not find the any drawback or any problem with that person, that assistant professor. Then they started a slogan that non-Hindi speaking OSD hatao. So, sir, why I am saying this, how this different strategies will arise in the university system and actions and reactions, right? So that because of this non-cooperation and this inconvenience in the university system, that person being the lecturer assistant professor, he has resigned several times for the post. So what happened finally, again the vice chancellor requested him to continue as a OSD. So it means finally what happened, finally that person has realized that he cannot continue in the university. Vice chancellor forced him, and then he can't, because the dean, head, all people are senior people, he cannot cope up with those people, and he decided to leave that university. And when he decided to leave that university, and he was again working as a lecturer at teaching and research, then he got opportunities for some other university, and he went there to work in some other university. Because of that university is not conducive environment for him to work. Then that person left that university and went to new university. And what happened when that person is going to other university, his entitlement right, his ultimate right is to get the lien. So the executive council of that university denied or cancelled the lien of the faculty members, and he was called back by the university, right? And then that guy, no option, he came back and he joined again the same university. After joining 3 months, again he was appointed as OSD by the same vice chancellor. So again his problem started. So in this case, what happened, that the assistant professor, he cannot compete with the senior professors. They are in all the committees, all the senior professors, this is a professional, you know, that professional jealousies. And what happened, that person applied for higher post, and after applying the higher post, and some way he was selected, and this people, the senior faculty member, tried to cancel his appointment by putting so many pressures. And that Mr. totally, that guy was struggling in the university. So finally what happened, after struggling that university, and that fellow, of course vice chancellor is meant for only 5 years, but faculty members, you are the faculty members, have to work in the university, I think more than 20 years, 30 years. The faculty teachers are long term, they have to work, but vice chancellors will come for only 5 years. We have to survey. Then finally that fellow, what happened, that guy, the day, fate of that guy, his promotion was stopped by the senior faculty member. When the promotion was stopped, that fellow, the 15, helpless, hopeless fellow, he continued the same position. And then when he was continuing the same position as a seniority, he became the member of the executive councils. His opportunities, threats and opportunities, Yes. So here, what I mean is that next after that, what happened? That this existing vice chancellor has gone, new vice chancellor has come, new vice chancellor came is different nature. In the different nature, he could not adjust with the nature. And then, so here, the person who is working in harnessed, some people will receive, some people will not receive. Some people will digest, some people will not digest. So in this case, what happened? Finally, what happened here? That faculty member has adapted different strategies to adapt in this, is to adjust or struggle in the university. But the university faculty members is always, these are the practical problems in the system. So that's why we, as individuals, we have to analyze self-assessment and then adapt the strategies for our. So in this case, now this is a small case study I'm putting in front of you. So in this case, what we have to observe, the university is trying to achieve its objectives, the vision and mission. The teacher is trying to achieve his objectives. Objective is that is the promotion, a higher education, higher level, and because every assistant professor want to become the professor. Of course, different stages we have to achieve. That is the ultimate goal of our every teachers. So everybody will try. In the process of this, so what happened? That persons, the each and every individual has to face different struggles. This, while facing these issues, you have to adapt the strategies. Different strategies. So in this strategies, I say that higher education will go for the SWAT analysis. Our individuals also, institution will go SWAT analysis. And of course, who are these? We have the higher education system. And in higher education system, we go for the SWAT analysis, strength and weaknesses, opportunities and threats. If you see the threats, now, so in this case, university vision, mission, objectives, we have to understand as a process. People, we have to understand this. And this, before going to this, we have to see the, of course, not only SWAT analysis, there are different tools. We have the tools, of course. This, there are SWAT analysis, PEST. PEST analysis means political and economical and social, technological, and PESTEL, one more package. PESTEL means political, economical, and social and technological, legal and ecological. And another tool is that scenario planning. That means it is explained about the future of the university, And then forecasting and projecting the university's objectives, forecasting the university after 5 years, where the university will be, what is the image of the university, what is the brand of the university. And then there is another tool, that is the Porter 5 forces of analysis. That is the, they are the potential starting point and the potential substitutes and the power of suppliers and power of stakeholders, potential strugglers. These are the, so this, there are different in each and every institutions will go for any, whatever the tool available for them, you will adapt. So in this case, in this analysis, now we'll go for the university vision, mission and objectives. So here, when you talk about the university vision and mission, first we should have the clarity of the function of the university, And then we have to understand the vision and mission clearly. What is the university mission? What is the university vision? And what are the vision? And then whether this vision and mission will continue in the nature, is it adjustable or sustainable or non-sustainable, that we have to assess. So then, to whom your university is accountable? In the vision, we have to realize that the universities or organizations or any institutions accountabilities. For whom this accountable? There are, of course, we have the courses, different courses, different students will join. They are the primary students, and then another is primary students market segments. It means finally, what are the any students? The students will go for the market, right? Whom we are accountable. And then objectives of the university. University's objectives, of course, we'll see the objectives of the universities. And then mission and vision of the universities. We have to get the clarity on this vision and mission of the university. Right? We'll see the next slide. Now, if you see the clarity of the vision or mission of the any university, right? Of course, I don't know how many members of the faculty members have visited the, seen the vision of the university or mission of the university. Manu, vision of the Manu or mission of the Manu. So here it is, I have not developed this, this is from your university's vision. The vision of your university is that to provide and to promote quality higher education and research through Urdu medium and be recognized as the leading institution for academic excellence. This is the vision of your university. I already told you that vision means very clear statement which is very achievable, and we can realize the vision. Is a very clear that no complexion, no complexity, no contrast, no conflict. Very clearly saying that to provide and promote quality higher education and research through Urdu medium. That is the specialty of the Manu. The Manu is the specialty of the why this university is the specialty significance of this university is that the education, higher education through Urdu medium. And then recognized as a leading institution for education. This is the common, every institution will have it. But your university vision is that the higher education provide and promote the quality of higher education, quality higher education research through Urdu medium. That is the specialty of the significance of your university. Then, to realize this mission, then vision, what is the mission? The mission of the Manu. Of course, if you see your, this is available in Act and Statute of the University. The mission of your university, mission of the university is number one, to disseminate knowledge. To disseminate knowledge through the medium of Urdu, the mission of your university. To disseminate the knowledge through medium of Urdu, to impart quality of higher education in Urdu through regular mode and distance mode. This is the mission. And to provide highest quality of teaching and learning and research environment to the students. And next is to develop the students' personality and enhance students' learning traits. And then to produce linguistically and socially responsible graduates who could make substantive contribution in the society and the nation building. That is the mission. And to empower Urdu knowing people, by providing the higher education access to them. So is the mission of your Manu. So now it means now, once vision is clear, mission is clear now, right? What are the strategies to achieve this mission? To realize this vision, right? If you see the next, what your university's strategies are, commitment are, values are, core values are, whole commitments of your university to achieve, realize this vision and mission, right? So now, first point, if you see that, supporting and implementing the, next slide please, next slide. Supporting and implementing its vision, objectives, objects and mission. Focusing on students' needs, right? Of course, these are the general strategy, general. Promoting continuous improvement in teaching and learning. Fostering research culture, facilitating the spirit of the scholarship in students, and promoting the notion of guidance beyond teaching among the teachers, manifesting the ethos of Urdu through its architecture and culture, channeling the resources and potential toward the nation building, establishing, maintaining and expanding green campus, beautiful campus we have. Here is a part of it. Involving stakeholders in the activities that affect them. Who are the stakeholders? Assessing and improving the policies related to with the academic and administration. Cultivating transparency in the administration. And preparing merit and quality in all spheres of the promotions. Recognizing the worth of all its teaching and non-teaching members. Treating all the students, staff and people of the country with dignity, right? Such a beautiful core values of the university. Very beautiful values. Of course, I think I request all the faculty to go through this values of the university. Values of the university, right? So in this case, now, right now, this is your university system. Now we'll see the higher education system in India. Higher education system in India. Right? Strength and weaknesses of the university's system, educational system. This is not your university, it's general. The strength and weakness of the universities not related to your university. It is a general perception, whole Indian university system. All right. Now, first one point is university strength. What are the to develop the higher education, to take the, to build the, to establish the image of the higher education and brand of the higher education, the university's higher education, the what are the strength? First, if it's a strength, the strength is independent thinking. This is the one advantage of each and every university has its own thinking. That means now interference is very less. The university have the capacity to think, to evolve, to develop, to abolish, to improve, to enhance, to reduce, whatever. So any ideas, thinking, thought process, it is independent of you, of the university. And then in the university system, university more is as the advantage of the creativity, the something new. The university will think, will develop the new innovative ideas, innovative thinking, innovative strategies, innovative schemes, innovative courses, innovative programs, right? Innovative diploma, whatever it is, skill programs. So all these things will enhance the employability of the students. Autonomy. So that means now university system, university is autonomy. Of course, now the creativity is independent thinking, autonomy. So now the each and every university is autonomous institutions. It has its own power. So autonomous means any institutions can have the new course, remove the courses, evaluate the courses, MOU, research, understanding. As the totally an independent power. So it means now academic freedom. We have the, so academic freedom means what to teach, what is the program, what is the course, what is the teaching program, what is the mode of teaching. It is online teaching and offline teaching, our class, our interaction, participatory, are different. All right. So then another is democratic participation. Of course, in the university system, you know that everything depends upon the committees. Anything, any grievances comes, anything comes, committees, because everybody is. That's why we are the different hierarchies. Executive Council, Academic Council, we are the different planning committee, finance committee, right? And then school boards and board of studies and faculty. We are the different committees. That means each and every, the process, right? Each and everybody is the part of it, decision making. That is called democratic participation of each and every stakeholders. And then it is when there is a democratic participation, then we can say it is a collective decision making. So so by seeing the strength, these are the strength. So apart from this strength, of course, the university system has the weaknesses. Right? What are the weaknesses? Right. Now weaknesses, performance. Right, the performance of the university. Right, performance of the university depends upon several factors. Right, is the faculty, good students. Right, good environment, good equipment, good management. Right, good leadership, academic honest. So performance is a multi-dimensional concept. It depends upon several factors. Right? If all this, I think I'll explain later this, what are the factors which influence the performance. And then what is the weakness recently? The diminishing financial support. Because the universities, the government is slowly withdrawing its support, financial support. Why? Because they are talking about the Atmanirbhar, self-reliance. The organizations have to develop their own resources. Sustainability. They have to develop their own resources. They should not depend on others. All right? This is the So one side, there is a trend of diminishing the financial support. Another is the people are talking about the performance. Of course, we'll see next. And then the private sector model of the performance. So in the private sector, what are the problems? What is the private sector? Why is the private sector? The private sector is working for only the profit-making purpose. If there is no profit, the private sector will not exist. But whereas the public sector motive is the only service motive. It will not go for the profit. That's why we go for the only service motive. Whereas the private sector main fundamental motive is the profit. So when the private sector is going for, because private universities are, like Muslims, many private universities are coming, right? Their model is that, what is their model? Corporate model. That's why we are talking about this today topic. So they say that their facilities, of course, all facilities and their at the same time their fee structure. Right, this one. Then alternative funding. Alternative funding means now, you know, the government is support is withdrawing. Another is that government has come with a new proposal. That proposal is that we are ready to give you the finance. That means loan. We are going to give you the loan. That loan, take the loan and construct or develop your buildings and you repay the loan. So that financial support is all loan based. Earlier it is a financial support, financial assistance, but now financial assistance are loan based. Right? This another is the faculty. The main is the faculty. This faculty is the base for any organization to sustain, but the main issue is recruitment. Recruitment and promotions of the faculty members in the each and every organization, institutions. Many vacancies, many faculty positions are vacant in the universities. Right? Even the faculty positions are vacant. Right? They are running the universities with the outsourcing faculties. Outsourcing means like, you know, so you take the class, you take this payment and go. No responsibility, no commitment, no risk, accountability. No accountability at all. Right? This is the very weakness of this. And then another is academic leadership. Academic leadership. So academic leadership, you know that now academic leadership means, you know that who are the leaders, academic leaders. Generally, we take the academic leadership means we take the vice chancellors. We know the vice chancellors, fate of the vice chancellors nowadays. We are seeing what type of vice chancellors are coming. Who are the leaders? Generally, these academic leaders, who are the academic leaders, right? They will not go for those who are academically well established, name and fame, right? They will not come for these type of positions, right? So here academic leaders means what happened? There are two categories, administrators and managers. Administrator means what? Administrator will administrate as per the rules. What rule says, right? He will do it. The manager is means manager also will follow the rules, but there is a small scope to manipulate the rules. Rule will be rule. Rule is rule. Rule is existing. He cannot go against the rule. He will go for the rule. But within the rule, he is the manager will try to manipulate. That is the difference between the administrator and managers. That's why now we can say that now you can realize that who are the academic leaders, who are the administrators, or who are the managers. Who are the vice chancellors, who is the administrator, who is the manager. You know, I already told you that the honest person, if any honest person in the university system, right, the university will not. Why? Because some university, some system, you know, because the people, those who are habituated in the administration, habituated for something extra benefits, right? If you cut immediately, right? Immediately, what happened is support, is cooperation. Right? He will withdraw. Now, his non-cooperation will start. So, what happened now? So, as a result, what happened? He will adopt the strategy. What is the strategy? The strategy of red tapeism. Strategy of the red tapeism. Lethargic. Okay, we'll do it. We will do it slowly. Right? These type of the things will arise in the, you know, system. If this situation continues, right? So, right now, what happened now in this circumstance, if after seeing the strength and weakness of the universities, now we have to go analyze the furthermore, what are the externalities? What are the externalities? So before going to externalities, what is the present as per the new education policy 2020? Higher education policy 2020. So the main objectives, what are the scenario you see there? The main objective of the new higher education. Number one is the access. In India, every person, every eligible candidate must be accessible. The education must be accessible to the persons, those who are. All right? And then accessibility is. So access, how the accessibility will come? Expansion of the university system. The expansion of the university system means what now? For example, the Manu is ESTAF headquarters in Hyderabad. Right? Now, it has the satellite campuses in different places where the most Hindi, Urdu speaking persons are existing. The areas. So they established campuses. Our campuses. It means now it is the process of expansion of the university. It means that is means of access. Provide the access to everyone. Let everybody get the access. Has the opportunity for higher education. All right. Next slide. Please, next slide, please. And access to education. No. Previous slide. Yes. And then next one is the next objective of the our education. Enhancing the equity. Equity means what? Provide the education equally to all the people. Equally to all the people. There is no chance of bias. Chance of discrimination. Everybody you live equally have the access. That's why our universities is open for all. Right? And then participation. Stakeholders means who are the stakeholders of the university stakeholders? Students and parents. And then go for the alumni. This that for students. Right, then next is the quality of the teaching and learning. Right, what is the quality of the teaching and learning? We have to, of course, now we have to increase the quality. What is the best strategy of our UGC has been implementing that API score, performance of indicators. The performance of indicators, you know that. I no need to explain. Quality of the publications, right? Quality of teaching, quality of learning, and research and innovations, right? To increase our quality of teaching. What we are teaching today, we are giving the only degrees. And after taking the degrees, for example, now any degree MA, if that person take the degree, you go to the market. What is the market for these people? And in this case, quality of teaching and learning and research and innovations, right? And then the globalization in this situation, what happened now? Everything become competitive, right? Today you have to compete with the persons who are well-developed countries. Developing countries, underdeveloped countries, each and every country has to compete each other, right? Now developing countries, underdeveloped countries cannot compete with the developed countries. All right? Some countries are socially, some countries economically forward, some backward. So here what happened? Because of the globalization, the competition increased. What happened in this competition? The persons who are the countries which are backward, they are not able to compete. But the opportunities. So what happened now? Wherever the now global leaders, academic leaders, for example, now Oxford or some other universities, some many universities are opening their branches in their countries where there is a market. Now every organization looking for the market, stakeholder, where is the market for them? So they are opening their branches. That's why we are the multi corporates, universities also open. And that's why we have now in India, we have the one university, Asian University. Only one university, Asian University. So that's what is the and delivery system. So what is the delivery system? So delivery system, you know, so we have everything, but when the thing is particularly when you go for any providing the facilities for the students, facilities for the faculty, facilities for the universities, or what are the schemes? These are the delivery system and what we are seeing. And decentralization, this is the one concept which is totally useful for the decentralized education. And then management. Now there is a need to, of course, new education policies focus on the best management system to develop the university system to provide the best higher education equal to the developed countries. And then resources and budget. This is the major issue where the government is focusing. And allocation of the resources and budget provisions for the. If you see the next, externalities for higher education. External issues are external issues for the university system. Political environment, economic environment, technological and government policies and community belief system. Right, in the education, university system, each and every factor is influencing the higher education system in India. Political environment is influencing. Political interference influencing the higher education system and university system. And the answer was that I respect the first my profession, my teaching, then I respect the vice chancellor. My priority is teaching, and after that, my vice chancellor. Then he left the class. And then this, after 2 weeks, he got my timetable on his table, and then he targeted me, and then he started monitoring me, whether I am the punctual or honest or not. Then that vice chancellor, suddenly, generally vice chancellor come to the office by 11, 11:30. But one fine day, 9:30 sharp, he came to my class. Without intimation, without any instruction, without notice. Yes, I was in the class 9:30. Sharp 9:30, he came sharp 9:30, I was in the class. So, why I mean that, this is the, yes, we respect the vice chancellor. We respect the administration. We respect, in the same way, chancellor, someday if he don't take the class, he himself is going to take the action. So that means now the administrator will play administrator role. So at the same time, when the administrator play the administrator role, as a teacher, we have to play our role. So this, if whenever you deviate this, then total system, finally, ultimately, what happened, this affect our career. Our main profession is that teaching, we have to confine to our teaching. And research, research. Then, if you are capable and able to, right, sacrifice your teaching and your research, then you can do something else. Then you are, that is the sacrifice. Right? This is the analysis. And then in this case, what are the strategies required for Indian higher education system? Of course, access, availability, accessibility, affordability, quality, employability. Right? Now, availability, if you take the one concept, availability of the education. Yes, we have nearly 1,000 universities in India. Nearly 15,000 or something colleges in India. Each and every, particularly if state-wise, you take the each and every state has its own universities, deemed, of course, university structures. We have the availability. Affordability, of course, state governments and central universities, affordability is there. But when the private university is the now question mark, now it is in dilemma, affordability. All right, this is the one, affordability. So when the higher education is given to the private people, the private people are playing the major role in higher education. This, why these private universities are not giving the corporate social responsibility? This strategy is to be needed. These universities should take the responsibility of social, corporate social responsibility, because these universities are not only universities, these universities are corporate universities. When the corporate companies are taking the responsibilities, corporate social responsibilities, this corporate social responsibility, CRS, must be given to the, all the private universities also. Then only affordability will be realized. Then come to the qualities. Quality of the education. Quality of the teaching. Right? The quality, again, performance depends upon several factors. Right? Quality depends upon several factors. The teachers. Teacher is appointed in the university and up to 6 months, no chair, no room, no bench, no class, nothing. You will be roaming in the university, no settlement. No computer, no facilities, nothing. No place to sit. This is not due to lack of resources. Of course, state university, there is a problem, financial problem, crisis. But whereas central university, not that much, but okay, comparatively, relatively better than state university. But in central university also, there is a problem because of the lethargic attitude of the management and affecting the quality of the, and the students and teachers, right? The quality depends upon all factors. It depends upon the teachers, it depends upon the students, it depends upon the management, it depends upon the administrators, it depends upon the government also. The government support is needed to increase the quality of the teaching. And then next one is employability. For employability, what are the strategies we adopt? The university will adapt. The employability is, now I will tell you, I was the placement in charge for the my university. I have organized placement in my university. I invited the 9 companies in Lucknow, corporate companies. I invited companies for campus recruitment. And nearly 500 students have appeared for the interview. This happened in 2009, 9 and 10. So what happened? 9 companies came, 500 students participated for campus recruitment placement. And the companies have selected only 200 students. Not student, less than 170 or 180 students. Then I was not happy with that. Vice Chancellor was also not happy with the recruitment. And then the university asked me to, analysis. So evaluation, where is the problem? Then I, again, one day, fine morning, I adopted one strategy of the tea party. I invited all the companies, corporate companies who attended the placement for tea party. So I organized tea party. I gave the good tea party. And then I requested them to identify the problems of the students. Please give me 10 or 15 problems. What are the problems or obstacles to take the more students from this university? And they gave the list of qualities of the students. All the qualities I have taken, and then I assessed, analyzed all the qualities. So it means what happened now? Whatever the degrees we are giving the student, those degrees are not suitable for their companies, the corporate companies. So they said that along with the degrees, you please provide some skills, soft skills along with the degrees. Degrees means for hard skills. But they require the soft skills. So then, the next strategy is to make the students more employability. We started giving the skills in the job skills. Means like a personality development. So in the personality development, we developed all the modules, different strategies. What the skills required for the students. We have developed and we train. And then after training of the 1 year, we have called for the recruitment. And then we go for the recruitment process. Then 1,000 students appeared, then the rate increased. Out of 1,000 students, they have selected the 700 students. So it means now employability means, we will talk about the employability of higher education. Right? What markets, it is linked to the market requirements. Now each and every university has to focus on market, collaboration with the markets. Right? Then only we can make the students employed. We have to provide not only the hard skills, we have to provide the students soft skills also along with our regular curriculum. This we have to adapt, then only we'll employability. So this employability is, and then with this, if we go for the different strategies, what are the, of course, we go for the analysis of SWOT analysis. We identify the education universities, strength and weaknesses, opportunities. So what a strategy generally universities will go, the strength and the opportunities strategy. So any persons or your organizations will have the opportunities to get his strength, right? That's why we go for the opportunity. What is, look for the opportunities? What are the opportunities? Any person is lacking some, right? In the, within the university, what are the opportunities? That's why we have the organizations are organizing different training skills, faculty development program. This is also one way of the program. So we have to look for the opportunities, and then they become the strength. It become the, that is the, is the strength. And then threats, if there are threats, if you see the threats, then you have to see the, what are your strength. Strength overcome the threats. strength, overcome the threats. Of course, each and everybody will have the threats in the organizations. Faculty members will have the threats. The threats will be looked after or overcome by the strength when you are identifying your strength. Each and every individual will have their own strength. What are your strength? You realized. And then weakness. When organization has the weaknesses, right? Then ultimately the organizations or individuals have the opportunities. What are the opportunities? To overcome the weaknesses. Overcome the weaknesses. And then develop the weaknesses. So when another way is the weaknesses, we have the weaknesses, then we have the strength. So in this way, the strategies for education are to be developed. Then in India, we need to develop the higher education linkages with the different organizations, partnership, understanding, and NGOs, social organizations, and then students, the more employable, increasing employability, and the increasing enrollment, right? The protecting the interest of the students, and the protecting the interest of the teachers, interest of the university, then only the universities will realize its objectives and vision and mission of the universities. Right? With this, I will stop it. Another, I will go for the discussions with these strategies and management and planning of this higher education. Right? Over to Raju.
Thank you, sir.